In this video, I'm gonna show you how to use Google Drive on desktop in 2022. And yes, this includes some of the best Google Drive features. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a frighteningly large amount of Google content. Today is your complete Google Drive tutorial. Let's go. Okay, I have made so many videos on Google Drive, but I find returning to the basics every now and then to be super helpful. So if you are totally new to Google Drive, let's start with what is Google Drive? Google Drive is a free cloud storage solution that features file storing, syncing, and sharing of files across your devices. So if you've ever created or read a Google Doc, for example, you've already used Google Drive. And pro tip, think of Google Drive as your storage garage where you keep all your docs, sheets, slides, photos, and more. So how do you access Google Drive? There are actually multiple ways to access Google Drive, but for me, I usually access my Drive from my Gmail or GCal, but you can even access it from your YouTube account. So it's gonna look the same from either spot you pick. So here we are in Gmail, and if we click on the Google Apps in the top right, it's this gray square made of dots. All your Google Apps will pop up here, and from here you can click on Google Drive. But there is also a handy keyboard shortcut you should know. In your browser bar, you can just type in drive.google.com, hit enter, and you'll be taken right to Google Drive, or you'll be prompted to sign into your Google account if you aren't already. And just so you know, they have Drive for teams or individuals, but for this video, we're just gonna focus on your personal Google account. So now that we know how to access Google Drive, let's take a look at the main layout. Your Drive may look a little different in this main section here, depending on whether or not you have created any files or folders, but the basic layout should be the same. We've got this navigation menu on the left-hand side, and here we also have the storage indicator. So this is gonna tell you how much storage your plan has and how much you've used, as well as a little button to buy storage if you need. Now, I've done a few videos before on how to clear up Google Drive storage, as well as what counts towards your Google Drive storage. So I'm gonna be sure to link to those below, but for now, back to your Google Drive layout. At the top, you're gonna have a search bar where you can easily search for files and folders. And we'll touch on some of these search functionalities a little bit later on. Now, the main section of Google Drive is this My Drive section. And as you populate your Drive with files and folders, you're gonna have those in this section here, along with some suggested files at the top. So these are typically files that you've opened recently and or often. Now, if your Drive layout still looks a little bit different than what I'm showing, you can just adjust your layout using this option near the top right to switch to list view or switch to grid view. It's a personal preference, so I typically lean towards grid view. Higher up near the top is where you're gonna find your settings gear, and to the right of that is, of course, those trusted Google app access. So now that you're familiar with the layout, let's learn how to create a new file in Google Drive and how to create a new folder in Google Drive. As you might be able to guess, you can click on New in the top left of your Google Drive, and here you'll have the option to create a new folder. Upload a file or folder, you can create a Google Doc, a sheet, slides, or forms, and you're gonna have more options underneath that as well. Alternatively, you can also just right-click on any empty space in this main section of your Drive here to create new files and folders. So if you don't have anything in your Drive yet, a good place to start would be to create a new folder. Think of how you wanna organize your files here. So as an example for this video, I've created a YouTube assets folder. So let's go ahead and create a folder. And I'm gonna create a client outreach folder and then hit create. And bam, right here under folders, you'll have your new folder. Now, If you are in list view, and I will toggle back to show that for you here, you'll be able to get a quick snapshot of the owner of the file, when it was last modified, and by who, as well as the file size, which is really handy. So I'm gonna toggle back to my grid view. So, if you wanna upload a file that already exists on your computer, we're just gonna head back to new and this time select file upload. Then just select the file you wanna upload and it'll be added to your drive. Essentially, any type of file can be uploaded. A video file, PDF, image file, Photoshop file, and on and on. Plus, you can upload multiple files at once by hitting Control Select or Command Select on a Mac. And just like you can upload a file, you can upload an entire folder as well. So now let's create a file from scratch. We will create a Google Doc as an example, and you can click on the Google Docs option, or you can hover over the arrow to the right, and you'll have the option to create a blank document or create a doc from a template. And by the way, you can use templates for any of these Google apps. So this is the perfect opportunity to talk about the power of templates. Though they've basically been around since the invention of Google Drive, templates remain to me one of the best Google Drive features. So check this out. Let's click on the Google Docs template option and a new tab is going to open up and you can scroll through a boatload of doc templates like resumes, letters, different types of project proposals, sales templates, legal templates, contractor agreements. There's just so much more. So if you're working on, I don't know, let's say a newsletter, just click that template and voila. The template is automatically opened for you to edit. So of course you're gonna be able to edit anything and everything from the title to the text to the colors and the layout, anything. So whether you create a new blank file or one from a template, this new tab is automatically opened where you'll edit that particular file. And now that you've mastered creating new files, you're gonna wanna keep all those files neatly organized in Google Drive. And lucky for us, there are a few ways to keep everything neat and tidy. So first, from the new file you've created, at the top near your title, click the little folder icon, select the folder you wanna move it to, and then click move. Now back in my drive, I can open my folder and there's the doc that I created. But you can actually organize your files and folders right from your main Google Drive dashboard too. All you have to do is drag and drop your files into their folders. And remember, like we learned earlier, if you've got a ton of stuff going on here, you can just right click, create a new folder, and then just start dragging files into that new folder all right from here without leaving this page. You can also right click directly on a file or folder to not only move it, but to access a whole whack of other features. So one of these handy features is the ability to star a file. Of course, we can do this from your opened file as well. That'll be up at the top near your file name, but why actually click to open a file when you don't have to? Instead, we'll right click on the file and star it right from there. And by the way, once you've starred something, it can now be found in the starred section in your Google Drive on the left-hand side. But let's take a look at all these options we have on right click. You can share it or make a shareable link, which I'll go over in a bit more detail later. You can show file location, move or favorite it, rename the file, copy the file, download it to your computer, or this is how to delete a file in Google Drive, and there's a lot more options here as well. There are so many features available with just a simple right click. Now, something else I like to do is color code my folders. So with that right click again on the folder, we can easily change its color. I like having this quick visual cue for my organization. Now, speaking of visual cues, something else you may have noticed is the different icons for different files. This is another quick visual cue from Google showing you without even opening the file, whether it's a doc or a spreadsheet, a PDF, or whatever it may be. So now let's talk about how to share files in Google Drive and how to set your sharing permissions. Remember how Google provides you with a visual cue as to what you're looking at? Well, if we go back to our list view for a second, if you have this little icon with a person in it by one of your files or folders, that means it's shared. Now, there are multiple ways to share a file. You can do it from the file itself when you're creating it, or you can do it right from your main Google Drive. So from the file itself, very quickly, you'll just click on the share icon near the top right. But back in our Google Drive, like I showed you before, you can right click on any file in order to share it. Or if you click to select a file, in the top right of Drive, you're gonna have a few new options here. If you click on the person icon with that little plus symbol, a sharing pop-up appears where you can add email addresses of those you wanna share with. Now you can have multiple people here if you want, and to the right of the person you're adding, you can set the sharing permissions here. You can allow them viewing access only, the ability to comment, or the ability to edit the document just as you can. Plus, you can even write a little message to your collaborators here too. Now, once you've got this all set and when you're ready to share, all you have to do is click on send. Now, if you want to remove somebody, you can do that too. You're going to head back to your sharing permissions. To the right of the email, you can click that toggle and transfer the ownership to them or remove their access entirely. Now, if you don't want to add people directly, you can also create a shareable link, so only people with the link can view the file. So with that file selected, just click that link icon in the top right, and in this pop-up, you can copy the link as well as adjust the link sharing permissions here too. So if you're new to sharing and collaborating with people, you're definitely gonna wanna check out my other video on that, because I go into detail on all the cool features about collaborating, like being able to view and respond and tend to comments, being able to see complete version histories of your files, which means you can see exactly along the way where and when someone made changes, things like that. But really quickly, while we're going over some of these sharing options, at the top, let's take a moment to highlight the detailed view. So with your file selected, you're gonna have this little info icon. If you click on this, a right side panel is gonna pop out, providing you with additional details about the file or folder you've selected. You're gonna see who has accessed, the file size, when it was created and modified, and by who. But as promised, another feature I wanna cover in this video is your search feature in Google Drive. Once you have a lot of files in your drive, you're gonna wanna easily pull them up without scrolling through pages and pages of files. So let's focus on that search bar at the top. Type in whatever it is you are looking for, and voila, that's going to appear for you. Now, I use this all the time since in my other Google account, I have all my YouTube scripts and there are a ton of them, and sometimes I just need to pull an old one up really quickly. So this is my go-to drive feature for doing that. But you can also access some advanced search features by clicking in the search bar and selecting advanced search from the dropdown, or just by selecting the search options toggle in the right of that search bar. So here you can now narrow down what type of file or folder you're looking for. You can select the owner of the file. If you know the name of the words found in a file, you can add that in, as well as a lot of other advanced search features. It's just so handy. So remember, if you want any more details on really any of this, I have a ton of other Google Drive videos all listed for you in the description below. Well, that's my Google Drive tutorial for you, and hopefully you learned how to use Google Drive. And now I want to hear from you. What are your absolute favorite Google Drive features and why? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like or share or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Google Drive content. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.